to give instructions for this four-round exhibition, Sudarsono.
There we get a look at the former champion. And he, of course, is on a losing streak since his...
You see over in Larry's corner, by the way, very popular ex-Kinzen, there's Sal Mambi, fighter out of Bronx, New York.
As we see the action there, there is Bernardo Mercado from Colombia, and he'll put his big body against Larry Holmes' body here. Two rounds of boxing with these two gentlemen, and then after Larry gets done with Bernardo, then James Quick Tillis rolls in to take on Larry for two rounds. It's an added attraction here at Senayan Indoor Stadium in Jakarta, Indonesia.
Mentioning Sal Mambi, Sal Mambi fought in the first world title fight ever staged in the country of Indonesia. A country that most people don't realize is the fifth largest population in the world, almost 200 million people squeezed onto all of these islands over here.
As we see the action, two gentlemen who have never fought, but we'll see the action right here. Round number one of two. This is just an exhibition, but you'll see some heated exchanges, we're sure.
And here we go. See if Larry still has that patented, sharp, snappy Larry Holmes jab.
Larry hasn't seen action in some two-plus years, ending up on the mat against Mike Tyson back in January of 1988. He told the Indonesian press when we flew in on Thursday that he would consider coming back. No guarantees, but we'll see.
Well, coming over on the plane with Larry, we talked about it a little bit. They were really, really comes down to money with him. Otherwise, and he has plenty of it already. But that's about the only thing that would coax him out of retirement. He felt there was only three credible pay-per-view type fights out there for him that the public would take seriously. One of those being a third fight with Michael Spinks, with both of them coming out of retirement. And both of those last two fights with both of them being very close, with Spinks getting the decision both times. Another one he mentioned was a fight, of course, with the other old warrior, George Foreman. The two of them never did get the fight the first time around. And the third one would be a WBO heavyweight championship fight with Italian champion Francisco Damiani. So those are the three fights that if he does come back, Larry's looking at. But important to point out, tonight's just an exhibition. Larry did not train for this. And is, by all accounts, you've been partying pretty good here in Jakarta.
Yes, and it has been a hospitable time here, shown the Americans who flew over the past 7 to 10 days. There's been dinners and parties, and Larry's been part in the center stage in all of them.
Well, Larry opened up on that last combination against Mercado here, so we might see it. Some punches start to fly here as the cordialities, as you will, are going to be thrown out the window.
Bernardo Mercado had a rather meteoric rise in the heavyweight division. He won his first 20 fights and then 17 by knockout, and then he ran into a gentleman by the name of John Tate and Mike Weaver and got knocked out back-to-back fights and pretty much just slowed his career down. Larry Holmes, the Easton Assassin, coming back for some little bit of workout here. Still showing some pretty good bounce to the legs. Will continue from Jakarta. More boxing exhibition with Larry Holmes after this. Stay with us. This is Dosan right now. As look, Mercado's really turning up the heat here a little bit.
Yeah, well, you've got two warriors in there. Want to show their best. There was a little hissing and booing here by the crowd who may have anticipated something a little bit different when they got here. And I don't think Larry, you know, would like to come home back to the States with any kind of a nasty cut. So you're going to see a lot of Vaseline out there and as much caution as possible.
trying to pick up the pace is Bernardo Mercado. And Larry Holmes came over here and was honored last night at a dinner and sang with his band. And gentlemen, just living a good life, really. And,
well, and he deserves it, Huey. You know, he was a very good champion, defending the title a lot, made some money, invested it in his hometown of Easton, Pennsylvania, owned some buildings as a hotel, a restaurant. That's why it would take quite a lot to coax him out of retirement. Crowd giving him a lot of trouble here right now, though.
Larry Holmes had 20 successful title defenses from 1978 through 1985. Unfortunately, he ended his career on a three-fight losing streak, twice to Michael Spinks, and of course, once to Mike Tyson, an ill-advised comeback in 1988. We'll have to see what his future plans will be, but as we said, he trained little for his exhibition tonight, but snapping the jab out there against the Colombian Bernardo Mercado. 48-3 was the former champion. Came within one fight of tying Rocky Marciano for the best record by a heavyweight.
And that was a bit of a disappointing night, obviously, for Larry. I don't know if everybody remembers. There was a lot of ballyhoo made about that record. They brought Rocky Marciano's brother into Las Vegas for the week, Peter Marciano. Quick Tillis just walked behind us. He's getting ready to come into the ring. And then not only did Michael Spinks become the first light heavyweight in history to win, to beat a heavyweight champion, but Larry didn't take it too well in the post-fight press conference, but of course has since apologized, and I think everybody's understood the situation at the time.
The jab working quite nicely for the former champion, who's picking up the pace here just a little bit. After Mercado had a pretty impressive first round, it's been the former champion, Larry Holmes, keeping the heat on as we round up the wind-up, I should say, the first two-round exhibition. Still to come tonight, of course, the main event, Tim Witherspoon on the card against Greg Gorrell. Witherspoon currently ranked by all the governing bodies as we wrap up here two rounds, but it's not over for the Easton Assassin. Nice exhibition by Bernardo Mercado.
Came into the ring to get into a fight with Lou Duva, of all people. And James Tillis did fight for the heavyweight championship back on October 3rd, 1981, where he took on Mike Weaver and went the distance over 15 rounds. So he's got an iron chin.
His finest moment might have been a 10-round.
What I talk bad about you, Larry Holmes coming over here to intimidate us by ringside.
The champion coming over and hoping the commentary with us is good as he dances with the ring girls. And I'll tell you, Arnie, he's a far more affable athlete now that he's through with the sport than he ever was during it. He never really reached the pinnacle of popularity that he had hoped. Of course, following Muhammad Ali is like following a legend. And I believe it wasn't until maybe the past 3 or 4 years that Larry Holmes maybe felt that he got the due he deserved.
Well, sometimes your history is written a lot later on than when you're actually participating. But Larry was screaming over here saying, "You're talking good about me." Larry had some very memorable battles with the press. Matter of fact, for the rematch with Michael Spinks, he barred the press altogether from his camp. In particular, I think at a press conference, he had the late Dick Young forcibly removed from the premises. So Larry's had his ups and downs with him.
Larry Holmes, yeah.
But I think he's got peace of mind now. Very proud of his accomplishments, both in the ring and out of the ring.
Nice right hand shown by the former champ. James Quick Tillis, possibly his finest moment, came in a loss. And won 10 rounds with Mike Tyson back in May of 1986, and many people thought that he might and indeed had won that fight. And to this day, he'll tell you he won it. Many people at ringside thought that he might have won that fight. But
it was an interesting point in Tyson's career. It was maybe, again, as we spoke about with Anthony Hembrick, a time to test going the distance. But, you know, it was also a time in Tyson's career where he used to get frustrated if he didn't knock somebody out early. And the first signs of that, as we look back in retrospect, was that James Quick Tillis was telling us something that we were all going to find out later on.
4 years down the road, and another James would do the number, James Buster Douglas. Right now you're looking at James Quick Tillis, and you might have to delete the Quick. He's put on a few pounds in the past couple years, but still moving kind of nicely.
There's something about boxers, Huey. We saw it with Muhammad Ali just fooling around the other day, where there's certain footwork and handwork that if they live to be 100 years old, just doesn't go away. It stays. It's like riding a bike. That lateral motion, the jab.
Larry Holmes is in the blue T-shirt, black trunks, and the Quick Man in the red trunks. And they're in round one of their two-rounder. Nice little uppercut by the Quick Man as he goes to the midsection, and there's some pretty hefty girth on both these gentlemen.
Well, as we mentioned, nobody went into serious training for this exhibition, and to a certain extent, they went into some serious partying over here in Jakarta, and it has been a fantastic week.
It has been tough not to party with these people. They've been more than hospitable.
There you go.
Good combination by Larry Holmes. And the Eastern Assassin working on the midsection of the man from Tulsa, Oklahoma, the man who still rides the Broncos. We'll take a timeout. We'll come back with round number two. Stay with us. This will be the final round of exhibition for Larry Holmes. And once again, heavy on the Vaso as he takes his fourth and final round. His second with James Quick Tillis. Certainly, the former champion has looked better and better as things have warmed up. And if he puts on a nice flourish here at the end, who knows? He might give second, third, and fourth thoughts to coming back. It's not out of the realm of possibility.
Well, he's stalking Tillis now, like the Larry Holmes of old. Ooh, that was a beautiful jab.
The jab is
reminiscent.
Still out there. The jab is out there big time.
But I think he would love to put Tillis down, just to put a little bit of doubt in everybody's mind about whether he could do it or not.
Yeah, and he's rocked him nicely.
Be interesting to see what Quick does now in response. And Quick's throwing his arsenal.
Now they're starting to yell, Ali, Ali.
Well, that's something that continues to haunt Larry even in an exhibition over here in Jakarta.